Okay. It's April. April 16th. Well, anyway, 1913 hours. Here is the new roller design. It's got a wooden frame on it. Using the bearings on there, it does seem to roll a little better without the aluminum stand. Same brass, but I'm using a pin. Cut the head off of the one and stuck the pin up in there, so that's what it's riding on with the bearing. Using the bottom one as the adjuster, the wood seems to grip it pretty good. So I'm not going to use any lock nuts on it. But it does seem to spin better. The other ones, I'm sad to say, I did not get the proper bearings locked into there, and they're just loose, and I'm going to have to do something with them. But anyway, this is the new design. Rotor is still out of whack. Not exactly round. The road, the magnets are not exactly round. This here, there it is. I have just one roller in this right now, and the best I could get out of it was 213 cycles per second, or 426. That's the fastest I can go with just the one. So here, it's only stable past a certain point. This is the frequency, that's the voltage. This is the current going under the grill. See, it's sitting on 6 amps. 40 volts. You will notice this jumping around because that's the roller. It's, I believe it's hitting on some of the magnets on the floor. It ought to play out. Thank you. Okay, so there it is. It's the only one we've got on there. It has not come loose, but it might be hitting a part of the core right here. That's a balance weight, an offset. It's not exact, but it's better than it was. So that's how it's mounted. It seems to have held up, but yeah, that's the upper limit, 426 RPM. So that's where we're at right now.